Good day, folks. So now we can take a look into the deployment and configuration of CDH cluster using Cloudera Kickstart VM. Okay, so we can use this for our testing and development purpose only, but not recommended for the production. For production deployment, you need to have multiple nodes, and also you need to use separate deployment mechanisms, which I have already shown in this video. So here so this is only for our testing and initial learning purpose only. So we can use our cluster for learning this Cloudera cluster by using this Kickstart VM. So I have summarized the steps here. Okay, so first we need to download any virtualization software and install it in your system, and make sure you have enough RAM in your laptop or desktop wherever you are installing. So you need to have minimum 8 GB plus RAM needed in your laptop. So first you need to download and install any virtualization software. So this can be either VMware or VirtualBox. So you can go to Google and search VMware player download and install, or VMware workstation. So workstation require a license key, and Oracle VirtualBox, that you can also download and install it in your system. And if you are doing it in your office machine, so you need to get a prior approval from your IT security team, and download this Kickstart VM. Okay, so you can go to the Cloudera website and download Kickstart VM. So there is separate VMs available for separate virtualization platforms. For VMware, so there is separate image. For Oracle VirtualBox, there is a separate image available, and also for Docker, some other images available. And once you download it, so unzip that Kickstart VM and open that using the VMware. Okay, so here I am mainly focusing on VMware, so which I have installed in my system, and I am opening with that VM using VMware, and then I will start services one by one once my VM is started. Okay, so these are the steps, and let's go to the site. First you need a virtualization software. Go to google.com and search for VMware workstation, or you can get a trial version of VMware workstation for Windows, or if you want to use it for a long term, so better use VMware player. Okay, so if you have downloaded and installed this VMware, so this VMware workstation, if you have workstation, it looks like this. So player looks like this. Okay, just open that VMware workstation, so it looks like this one. Okay, so let me remove this one which I have already. Okay, so this is the VMware workstation window. Now let me go to this Cloudera website. So https://cloudera.com/downloads. Go to this website. Okay, and here you can see on downloads https://cloudera.com/downloads.html. So you can see the quick starts. So this is the one which I am going to download. So download, press download button, and here, so you have to select the which platform you need. So if you have VMware based virtualization software, you have to select VMware, and if you have VirtualBox, then use that KVM, then use this one. So I have VMware, so I'm selecting this one and get it. So it there are two options. Okay, so one is you can fill all these values and continue, then immediately you will get that product. The second one is if you already signed up, then you can use using sign in. So you can use all the information here. Okay, so this is for self-learning, and your name, your last name, then business email, company name, then country, job role, everything you type, then continue, it will start downloading. Otherwise, if you have already have an ID, just do sign in with your ID and credentials, then submit. So it will download. So I'm not downloading at this time because I already downloaded the product. Okay, so I have downloaded this into this directory. Okay, so first thing I need to do is I need to extract this, extract all then extract to this directory, extract. It takes some time because it's around a 5 gig zipped file. So once after unzipping, so it will again reach near to 10 gig plus. So you need to make sure you have enough disk space. So now I'm able to unzip it properly. Okay, so this is the file, and again if you check the size, it's around, okay, so you can check the properties and see it's around 7.9 gig. Then go to that directory and make a note of this directory. So this directory contain lot of files. So this, some are the disk files, some are the so this is the VMware image files. So open to the VMware. So if you have select workstation, then go to the file and open a new virtual machine. Sorry, not this one. File, open. Okay, so it's not new virtual machine. So open, just click open, then go to the directory where you have, yeah, so go to this directory. Okay, so this is the directory which I have, then select that VMware image file. Okay, I'll show you once again. Then just file, open, then go to the directory, so where you have unzipped. So I have unzipped in VM's directory, inside that extract VM, then again, so this is the file, then open. Okay, so now you can see a new virtual machine is open, but by default it's around 4 gig RAM and one processor. So better you can edit this machine and add some more RAM. So I'm doing it in a 16 gig laptop, so I can edit this and add a few more memory. So till here I can use, okay, I use the maximum memory. So that is that's on. And again I need to add this processor also, because I think it's asking two minimum of two processors. Okay, so after that, so you can start this machine. Okay, so make sure you have increased the RAM, or at least 8 gig also okay, but here I have enough memory in my system, so I'm selecting it as 13 gig. So with 8 also it works. Then so power on this virtual machine. Okay, so initially it may take some time, 1 or 2 minutes maximum to start that virtual machine. Okay, so wait till then. Okay, so since I am doing the initial initial unzipping and starting, so it takes some time, few minutes. So wait till then, because initially it may take some time to start this machine and get this console. So if you look into the backend, you can see the file size also got increased. So initially around 7 gig, so that reaches to 20 gig. Again, this growth definitely requires some time. So let me do a full screen of this page. So, or else, okay, so if I'm comfortable with this is also okay. Okay, so this is the machine information. So initially you will get a page like this, the default page. Then I'm selecting this Express Edition again. So based on the configuration and other details, if you can go to this download page, and here you have the documentation. So that mention about the system requirement. Okay, so 64 bit, you need to have a 64 bit VM supporting virtualization software, and these are the compatibility, and this is about the RAM size. So 8 gig plus, then enterprise trial request 10 gig plus. I'm selecting Express because only the difference with enterprise trial is enterprise trial supports navigator and other extra features. So apart from that, if you require the common components or generic components, ecosystem components, so Express is more than enough. Okay, so we'll go here and launch this Express, select that. Okay, so again, it takes some time, so because it has to start those services, and then after that, you can open the browser and use 7180 IP. Or I think they already bookmarked that page, so you have to wait till this operation finish. So you can see the progress here. So it's starting Cloudera manager and other components. Okay, so wait some time. So again, it also take some time. So we have to wait till this operation finish. Then after that, we can open that web browser and see the status of different components. Okay, so the operation is completed. So if you press launch Cloudera Express, okay. So it take some time, so maybe 5 to 10 minutes, so please be patient till that operation completes. So once that is done, so that terminal will automatically close. Okay, so that's it. Again, it takes some time, so please be patient during that. So and so next thing, you can connect the Cloudera manager. So we have two options. Just type ifconfig and find out the IP address. Okay, 192.168.232.128. So use that IP here, http://192.168.238.127.780, or else, so there is one more option. So you can open the browser here, so application, okay, so I think somewhere you have the browser in your home page itself. So let me open the browser. Okay, so our browser is here. Open that browser. So this is the one just near to system, and you can click Cloudera manager here. So from here also you can open the Cloudera manager window, or else you can open it from outside if you know the IP address. Okay, so both will work in the same way. So I'm doing it from inside the Cloudera manager itself. So Cloudera, then accept the policy, then so admin, yeah. So I am inside the Cloudera manager window, so let me enlarge it. So again, that takes some time. Okay, I am more comfortable this while accessing from outside. So let me log out from the one inside the Kickstart VM and open, do it from outside. Okay. So that's it. Let me close it here. Okay. And continue here. So login with the default credential. So admin, then password is also admin. So default initial credentials. Okay, so you can see the Cloudera management services all are up and running. And here on the left hand side, you can see all there are a lot of services hosted, but start only those what you need. Okay, so no need to start the remaining services. So start whatever the services you need and its dependent service components. So I am just starting the HDFS, Hadoop distributed file system. So HDFS service first. Okay, so this service is up now. If I see that, okay, so let's wait some time and see the status. So it has to change it to green. Wait some time. So here the main, you can see there can be lot of issues related to the memory and other things, because we don't have much memory here. So even though we have a 12 or 14 gig, that is not completely okay. So concerning health HDFS canary, so that you can ignore that. Then what are the other components you need? Okay, so if you need to run MapReduce job, so you can start this yarn service also, start. And again, if you want Hive, then you can start the Hive services also. So make sure you are starting only the services that you really need. Otherwise, so the service itself consume some amount of memory. Okay, so once HDFS is started, so we can open a putty and check the connectivity, and we can also check whether we are able to access HDFS file. Then use that IP, then open, then use the credential. So user is Cloudera and password is also Cloudera. Okay, so we got the login, and this Cloudera user has sudo su, I mean, so it can switch to super user by using this command, then come back. So hdfs dfs hyphen ls slash, so check whether we are able to access this HDFS, whether we are able to write this and read the contents inside the HDFS. Okay, so let's check the status of other services also. It's still okay, so this is completed. Okay, and you can start whatever the services you need. So let me start Hive also. Start this one. Okay, so it's taking some time because we just started this service. So it takes some time. So maybe this as it may be in the safe mode and other operation in going in backend. So keep the machine for some time. Then after some time, so it will be stable and you would be able to access these directories. So this service also started. Okay. So this HDFS service has got some health related issue. So we will check that and try to troubleshoot. So we will see that free space related issue, then name node health issue. Then because we again so need to address all these things, because this is a very small VM, and again we don't have much disk space also here again. Out of 59, okay, fine, somewhat okay. Okay, so you have to wait some time, and after that it will be stabilized, then we can start using this cluster, and we have almost all components available here, and again so we can start whatever the services we need. So this is how it looks like. Okay, so it's very easy. So you can download any of the virtualization software, and then corresponding to that virtualization software, so you can use the downloaded VM. Okay, so that's it about the installation and configuration. So I hope this helped you. So please press the like button, also subscribe to my channel. Thank you, bye.